Okay, so this time is I gotta bite the bullet and I actually gotta work on the importation of data, like a proper system rather than this kind of hodgepodge of functions spread all over the place. And fix up the groups, because right now they're also kind of in the middle of a mess. Because I want to put more functionality into each particular group. Right, it's not just the index generator, it's an index generator plus a maybe an editor name, and the ability to retrieve data from the group on demand, or as on demand as we can anyways. So what that means here is I'm going to need to look at this group importer system. And it can't be using find resource. So let's see if, because eventually this will go up to ECS and be integrated into a per group basis. So we'll have to do like distributed. Something like that. With an importer. Grab the header. Distributed. Importer. Yeah, importer and exporter will be separate. Yeah. Find file. Can I find a file? And then, okay, what would I do? Let's say I request, I want to find a resource. I have the faux ID. Okay, so. Return like a YAML node right now, I think is the idea. And that would be how it works. It returns a node and like import the data, or would I just say like I just want to import data and then it works, it does everything automatically by itself, and then I'd pass it the ECS group or the ECS state data, resource data kind of structs that. See, right now the system is still disconnected. It's still kind of isolated by itself. Like the loading of all this stuff just has no bearing on the final one yet. So perhaps what I should do is what I'll do is I'll do a loose function, I think. What will happen will be because what it would have to write. Okay, loose function. Maybe like a bool. Get resources node. Get resource node. Oh, ID. ID. Like that. And it'll be YAML. That's what we're getting. And then we'd have a distributed YAML. this wonderful stuff. What this does is mostly this. So from the initial path that we have. So we have a bunch of search paths. Would it be? Okay. Because right now it's based on search paths still. I'm already have. Okay, no. Public blah, whatever, and then we'll have. But will eventually also be private, but right now it's public. We have the root node, the roots. Root dir, something like that. Standard file system path that. And we have the get resource node, which will try to return. Right now, it'll return the YAML, so it'll completely obliterate or the file handling will be completely inside of here instead, I think. So what will happen? Is we'll go through four and then we'll have like I guess this will be the directories I guess directory path. So we'll have constant entity data, state data. Sure. When we create this, it is created with directory and it must exist and stuff like that. Okay, then inside of here, we're going to go through all the cursive directory iterator to find what we're looking for. Correct? I think so. I'm pretty sure. Vendor entry. not iterator, it'll be like just m root dir slash c resource sub dir. Something like that. Now, so does that actually work, or are you just yanking me, Shane, on that? build. I don't even have it being built anyways yet, so ABCD distributed. Okay, const expression. Oh, static const expression. There we go. Okay, yes, it will work. Let's not return anything, that's fine. Always return false. Get resource node. Yeah, it'd be going into that. So regardless of whether either of these, it does have to go through this function where it's going to actually parse is regular file. Then I have to, like, you know, parse file name, I guess file stem, where okay, and then we kind of basically do this stuff. Assuming a non-persistent type. Or what would that be? That'd be just standard string. So take the... no, we just take the file name. ID. Not equals ID. I mean, technically, both should work. Continue. So we've got the group stem. I'm just going to parse the whole thing. I don't really care too much for stem end. Then we get to this. Something. So this will be what? Let's just say I'm looking for a very specific ID all the time. And that's it. I'd have to, if it's being changed in other subdirectories, then I'm going to have to change the ID for that. But that's not the responsibility of here. This is just going to parse the group and the index. That's it. Actually, if I do that, let me double check. ID, when I write the ID, right, it is just index and the group ID. Perfect. It's not actually. It'll be what? Not zero, it'd have to be like for ECS groups persistent. Something. I'm not entirely sure. I may need a very a special group value. Say like invalid group. So I have to reduce it by one. ID index. Where is that coming from? Actually, did I not remove like resource ID? I didn't. That's gone, right? And that's not going to break anything while I'm here. Okay. distributed YAML. It's that. If this is empty, just return that. Otherwise, we're going to parse it, which means string to unsigned long, index the index stem dot c string and character base zero. It's normalized to decimal. Otherwise, if equals the ID we're looking for, then we want to do parse call. Not parse call, we read in the file and then return it. Would mean, I got it down here somewhere, right? For armature, come on. I thought I had it. Nobody has it? Okay, maybe it's part of the, this. Just do this. Open the damn thing. We'll include for log. What else? That's all we need. Ready? Right. I need to return. Okay, now all this is hiding in the one directory, so I can probably go into application, include this locally. State YAML, group importer, just remove that file, don't care. And then we're going to have it's going to be this directory. That's what I'm caring about right now. Okay. So then we come down into wherever this file, this function is used, which is just down here. Dot get resource node, which will be for ID file root node. Ah, it failed horribly. Lovely. Okay, we go inside and see what went wrong and where. What? Unable to read. Data state the data E. Mroot dir becomes this. Oh, right. Yes. Because this is local to here, and that's it. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, that's a dumb move. We'll just put this as part of the whole thing right now, I guess. It's part of this section, I guess. Okay, mroot dir. Data state the data E. Sub resource is that. So we gotta go through. Bam. If this is a regular file, which is what? It's one. Four. Nine. What am I looking for? 12. 2, 7, 8, 3, 0, 5, 10. Come on. Twelve. Okay, we're in. We got it. We open the node. We leave with the true. Then we read the stuff. It does not read properly at all. For another thing. So what we do is we just kill that. This function just disappears. Just like that. And then we're going to go through into here and have a look at what's going on in here. Yeah, hold on. What are you doing? What's with the ID thing? We don't need that if we're just returning that instead, right? I don't really need this. Don't need this. Don't need all this. That's what we need. It's just this. And then we can do the same for the others. Not quite, actually. Not quite. What did it say? Oh, it's already gone. We're talking about armature, right? Yeah. Okay. Eventually, we'll have to go back through the reader again. But, oh, right, because this is looking for the file right now. Okay, I need to switch this around to using to deal with YAML directly, YAML nodes directly, not dealing with the file stuff. Yeah. Okay. let me just pause this for a moment. Okay, let's do that right now. Armature resource. So it's not this, it's that's the thing we're putting in. We have a YAML mode. Not file system, but that instead. Not entirely sure on their exception handling quite yet. So the YAML read armature definition. I'm going to turn it to that. Yeah, it's not going to be that. It's going to be file root node. That, then we get rid of this, then we get rid of these all the way to this point. Okay, so again, we've massively reduced this back down. I wouldn't want to keep doing it for the others, so I guess just move on to mesh, really. So one thing we want to do is go to the mesh function, reading the definition. So basically becomes this again. That's the entirety of the function. Material. Don't need this directly anymore. We just need is that and that really. Those are can be like declared as structs. Maybe. If I just do this, like nothing shows up, right? If I deliberately break it, nothing shows up. Okay, next is image definition. Not quite. Why? What happened here? YAML read image definition. That. Public. Still good. This leaves one more. The vertex script. No, two more. Vertex descriptor and shader loader. Shaders. Yeah. Okay. We'll just do these together. I'm pretty confident in this YAML. Shader definition. Just massively shrunk down again. So, what I need now is, do I want to go through like the search path mechanism, or do I want to go through continue with the distributed reader system? They're all very required. It'd probably be something along this line that I want to do first, really. So, Ultimately, what I don't want to be throwing, like, I don't want to throw the YAML node around outside of this class, really. Ideally, what this class will do is it will just, like, I request IDs data, and then it would just return the data if it was found. Whether it was gathered from a binary, or, because so there would be like a base class underneath this, presumably, or something like that. And how would I like? Obviously, like, I'm not gonna build like a whole bunch of functions like, get mesh data, get mesh resource, get armature resource, get whatever resource, because that confines me too hard to what I already have and requires like an intimate knowledge of the code base to work to add new ones. I don't want to have to do that. I want to be able to return something a bit more generic or just have one function that does a lot of them. As long as it's a resource, I can get the stuff, basically. As long as I can read it from the other side. And then I would compare, like, is this the resource type that I was looking for or not? I think that'll work. I think that would work best. But how? How to implement this? Okay. It'll have to probably be something like this. Or maybe a bool. It'll be like a void star star, and then it'll be like p create info. This will be the info it retrieves. And then based on it probably since we're CPP, C++, it would be we'd have some kind of base class like importer or resource. Okay. Something like that, which would be inherited from. For all the ones, and we'd have foo create info base is defaults virtual something like this. All the resource create infos would all inherit from this. This would be empty, just a destructor, which would of course be them. Then we return that. Maybe return a unique pointer, but I don't really want to deal with the memory nonsense. That would mean as we add items, we can expand the old ones or thinking real hard. Okay. What is okay, I'm gonna have to think on this. I'm gonna have to sleep on this. So I'm gonna end today's there. I shrank all that down and I'm gonna have to think how I'm gonna expand this properly. Cheers.